This tutorial introduces some of the basic features of RocSlope. The model used in this tutorial is an open pit with measured structures of known orientation, size, and location. Assuming that the failure of the slope is structurally controlled, you'll be using the defined joint structures to form blocks which may become unstable. To begin, open the RocSlope program. You will see a blank workspace. The first step is to configure the analysis parameters for the model in Project Settings. Select Analysis, Project Settings, or click on the icon in the toolbar. In the Units tab, set Units to Metric, Stress as MPA. Select the Analysis tab. Set Design Factor of Safety equals 1.2, and turn off Successive Failure, since you'll only be analyzing blocks which daylight and are readily removable. Then, click OK to save the settings and close the dialog. RocSlope is designed with an intuitive workflow to help guide you through the required steps in creating a model. Under each workflow tab, the toolbars and menus are customized to provide you with the functions needed in each step of creating the model. You'll begin with the Geometry workflow tab to define the materials. Now select Materials, Define Materials, or click on the icon in the toolbar. The Define Materials dialog allows you to define the unit weight of the rock and groundwater settings. Note that since the failure is assumed to be structurally controlled, rock mass strength is not considered in the rock analysis. Instead, the shear strength of the joints are used to model shear resistance to sliding. Ensure Material 1 is selected from the list on the left side and enter the following: name as schist, unit weight as 0.026, leave the default groundwater settings, i.e. where no groundwater is applied. Select Material 2 from the list and click the Delete button to delete Material 2. Do the same for Material 3. Select it from the list and click the Delete button to delete Material 3. Click OK to save the changes and close the Define Materials dialog. You will be using a pit shale surface geometry to create the external geology. To import the pit shale surface geometry into RocSlope, ensure the Geometry Workflow tab is still active. Select File, Import, Import Geometry. Several geometry file formats are supported. You can check out the RocSlope online help to see the full list. In the Open dialog, go to the Quick Start folder located in your Tutorials folder, select the Open Pit Surface file, and click Open. The Import Geometry dialog shows the file and mesh entities available for import and a preview of the entity. Using the dropdown, set the Geometry role to Geology. Select the All Geometry checkbox to select all entities. In this case, only one mesh entity exists. Click Post Processing, then click Done to import the geometry. The geometry is imported into RocSlope and added to the Visibility tree. The Visibility pane is located on the top left of the application window and shows a tree of entity objects in the model. Select the Open Pit Surface entity in the Visibility tree. The entity will be selected and highlighted red on screen, and the following information can be seen in the Properties pane: the name, the entity, which is surface, the role, which is geology, and the transparency. To create a valid external for modeling, convert the surface of the open pit to a volume. Select the open pit surface from the Visibility tree. Select Geometry, Create External from Surface. The Create External from Surface dialog allows you to set the bottom of the volume either by elevation or by depth. In the Elevation tab, set the bottom elevation to 500. Click OK to extrude the model down to an elevation of 500 meters and set the volume as an external. Now select the open pit surface entity in the Visibility tree. The properties have changed to the following. We see the name, now the entity is volume, the role is geology, and the applied property is schist. Note, the external may consist of several geology volumes, and a different material property can be assigned to each volume piece. In RocSlope, different geology volumes and material properties may have an impact on the block's weight, since the total weight of the block is the sum of all volume pieces, and each piece may have a different unit weight, the joint's shear strength if the strength is set to override by material, and the joint's water pressure if the water pressure method is set to the material dependent. In this model, there's only one material volume. Without the consideration of loads and supports, the stability of a geometrically removable block depends on the shear strength of the joints on which it slides. To define joint properties, navigate to the Joints Workflow tab. Select Joints, Define Joint Properties. The Define Joint Properties dialog allows you to define the strength model, waviness, and water pressure for each joint property. Select Joint Property 1 from the list on the left side of the dialog. Enter the following: name equals smooth. Under the Strength tab, strength type is more Coulomb. Cohesion is 0. Phi is 10 degrees. Override by material is false. Waviness is 0 degrees. And then under the Water Parameters tab, water pressure method equals dry. Add another joint property by clicking the Add button. Enter the following properties for joint property 2. Name is undulating. Under the Strength tab, strength model is more Coulomb. Cohesion is 0 kPa. Phi is 10 degrees. Override by material is false. Waviness is 3 degrees. Then under the Water Parameters tab, water pressure method equals dry. Click OK to save and close the Define Joint Properties dialog. The two joint properties model joints which are heavily weathered, providing very little shear resistance. In this example, you'll be defining joints using measured orientation data from a CSV file. You can easily add a list of joints where each joint, the orientation, location, and size is known. To define measured joints, ensure the Joints Workflow tab is still active. Select Joints, Define Measured Joints, or click the icon in the toolbar. The Define Measured Joints dialog is an Excel-like spreadsheet which allows you to easily input, drag, copy, paste, and import data. Formulas are also supported. Each row represents a single joint. Each joint is defined by a dip, dip direction, and modeled as a planar disk with its center at a location of x, y, z, and a radius. A different joint property can be assigned to each joint either by using the joint properties defined in the Define Joint Properties dialog, or by specifying a different set of shear parameters for a given shear model. Select Use Joint Properties. You will be assigning the joint property from one of the two joint properties defined from earlier. For this demonstration, you will be importing the orientation data directly from a CSV file. Click the Import CSV button. In the Open dialog, select the Upper West Joint Mapping Data CSV file from the Tutorials Quick Start folder and click Open. In the Import CSV dialog, set the data delimiter to comma. Set the start row to 2 to skip the first header row. Under the Data Column selection, set the following: dip equals 1, dip direction is 2, location X is 3, location Y is 4, location Z is 5, radius is 6, joint property is 7, and additional column H is 8. Click OK to import the CSV data. In row 1 under the radius column, set the formula to equals H 1 half. Half of the joint's persistence is assumed to be the radius of the joint. Drag the formula all the way down to the cell in the 85th row. Note that formulas in this grid control work like Microsoft Excel formulas, which is denoted by equal, followed by an expression. Assign the first 10 joints the joint property undulating, and the remaining to the joint property smooth. To do so, right-click and select Assign Joint Property to All, and then select Smooth. All populated rows are assigned with Smooth under the Joint Property column. Select the cells in the Joint Property column from rows 1 through 10 and right-click, then select Assign Joint Property to Selected, and then select Undulating. The selected 10 rows are assigned with Undulating under the Joint Property column. Click OK to save the inputs and add the joints to the model. Select the measured joints entity in the visibility tree, and the following information is shown in the Properties pane. The name, Measured Joints, the applied property, Measured Joint 1. Currently, only one set of measured joint data is supported by RocSlope. RocSlope has a two-part compute process. The first step is to compute the blocks which may potentially be formed by the intersection of joints with other joints and the intersection of joints with the free surface. To compute the blocks, navigate to the Compute Workflow tab. Select Analysis, Compute Blocks, or click the icon in the toolbar. As compute is run, the progress bar reports the compute status. Once the compute is finished, the results node is added to the visibility tree, and all valid blocks are shown in the 3D view. The results node consists of the collection of valid blocks and the socketed slope. The original external and measured joints visibility is turned off. Note, a valid block includes any block which is not attached to the non-terrain surfaces. The non-terrain surfaces are the sides and bottom of the model and is automatically determined by RocSlope. The blocks are colored according to the Block Colors option. The Block Colors option is available in the Result Node's Property pane or in the Display Options dialog. By default, block colors are set to Random Colors, which colors each adjacent block a different color to be able to easily distinguish between different blocks. This program default for block colors can be changed in the Display Options dialog. For this tutorial, 290 blocks have been computed, although some may be invalid. This is indicated by the computed blocks 290 on the status bar at the bottom right of the application window. Compute blocks only determines the geometry of the blocks. In order to obtain other information, such as the factor of safety, Compute Kinematics needs to run. The second and final compute step is to compute the kinematics for each of the valid blocks, including the removability, forces, and factor of safety. To compute the block kinematics, ensure that the Compute Workflow tab is selected. Select Analysis, Compute Kinematics, or click the icon in the toolbar. As the compute is run, the progress bar reports the compute status. By default, after Compute Kinematics is run, only removable blocks are shown. To show all blocks, select View, Display Options, or click the icon in the toolbar. In the Display Options dialog, navigate to the Results tab. Change Result Set to All Valid Blocks. Click OK to close the dialog. Note, alternatively, the result set can also be selected from the Properties pane of the Results node. The Removable Blocks and the Failed Blocks result set options are only available once Compute Kinematics is run. The status of the kinematic compute is indicated by the Kinematics Computed on the status bar at the bottom right of the application window. Once both blocks and kinematics are computed, all block results can be viewed in a grid format. To view all block results, navigate to the Results Workflow tab. Select Interpret Block Information, or click the icon in the toolbar. The Block Information pane shows the collection of blocks according to the result set selected. Currently, all valid blocks are listed. A number of columns with information are available. Any of the columns can be hidden. Let's hide the Volume, Driving Force, Resisting Force, and Number of Joints columns. Select Visible Columns on the left side of the Block Information pane. Uncheck Volume, Driving Force, Resisting Force, and Number of Joints. The columns are now hidden. The rows of block data can also be filtered. Let's filter by blocks which have a minimum weight of 10. Select Edit Filters from the left side of the Block Information pane. Set the block weight minimum to 10 and hit Enter. Blocks which are filtered out are not listed in the block information grid, and are also not colored according to the block colors option selected. A message, Block Results Are Filtered, is displayed at the top of the center of the perspective viewport. More advanced filtering criteria can be specified in the full filter editor. Select the Hide Blocks Excluded from Filter checkbox so that only the socket is shown. In both cases, the entry is not shown in the block information grid. To save the current filter, select the Current Filter button at the bottom of the Edit Filter section. A list of selected filters can be selected from at a later time under the Saved Filters section. To remove the current filter, select the Clear Current Filter button. To see the detailed information for a given block, select the block's block ID. For this example, select block ID 32 from the rows of the block information. This can also be done graphically by selecting a block in the 3D view. Click the See Block Details button. The Detailed Block Information dialog shows the 3D model of the block, general block information, as well as detailed information for joints, joint line of intersection, and block vertices. Select the Filter button at the top of the Joints table to modify the visibility of columns in the table. Click on the More or Less control at the bottom left of the dialog to expand or collapse the section containing the Joint Line of Intersections and Block Vertices tables. Export the block information to CSV using the Export to CSV button. Click Close to exit the dialog. Not only are the magnitude of critical values important to be aware of, the location also matters. The Contour Blocks option allows the users to plot a safety map of various block metrics so that the range of values can be visualized over the slope. Let's show the contour of the factor of safety. To show block contours, select Interpret Contour Blocks or click the icon in the toolbar. From the Legend pane to the right, select Factor of Safety from the second dropdown. All the removable blocks are contoured by Factor of Safety. The minimum Factor of Safety blocks are contoured red, while the blocks with a higher Factor of Safety are contoured blue. These contour options can be customized by selecting Contour Options. From this heat map of Factor of Safety, locations with the lowest Factor of Safety and highest failure risk can be identified. To contour blocks by failed weight, select the Results node from the Visibility tree. In the Properties pane, set the result set to Failed Blocks. In the Legend pane to the right, select Weight from the dropdown. From this heat map of failed block weight, locations with the largest failed volumes can be identified. The translation animation of the blocks is possible for any blocks which are removable. For the current result set of failed blocks, all blocks are removable since failed blocks are essentially a subset of removable blocks. To translate a single or multiple selected blocks, select Interpret, Translate Blocks, or right-click in the viewport and select Translation, Translate Blocks. Select a block graphically by left-clicking, holding, and dragging a block in the viewport. When done, right-click and select Done to exit the block translation mode. To translate all blocks, select the Results node from the Visibility tree. In the Properties pane, use the Block Translation slider to translate all blocks. To reset block translation, you can do one of two things. Select Interpret, Reset Translation to move the blocks back into the socket, or click the Reset Translation button in the Properties pane beside the Block Translation slider. This concludes the RocSlope Quick Start tutorial.